فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
Started amongst the shabab of Ikhwan al-Muslimin, the youngsters, the youths of Ikhwan al-Muslimin, في سجن, in prisons. في أواخر, this was at the late stages of what? The 50s and the 60s. وأنهم تأثروا, and they became affected by بفكري, the ideologies of who? الشهيد سيد قطب كتاباتي, سيد قطب and his works. وأخذوا منها, what is it that they took from it? What did they take from it? They took from it أن المجتمع في جاهلية, that the society are upon جاهلية. كفار. وأنه قد كفر حكامه, and he made takfir on the leaders. الذين تنكروا, those who have refused and become stubborn from the حاكمية of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah's judgments. That's what he said. So this is where it really sprung from. And if you read many other works written by other individuals, they all say to you, this is where they got this concept from. This is where they got it from. So this is another whole discussion itself. But the reality of the matter is, you will never today see a takfiri illa wa yu'adhim Sayyid Qutb, except he honors and he venerates Sayyid Qutb and he glorifies Sayyid Qutb. You find that every takfiri, khariji, da'ishi, will honor and he will venerate Sayyid Qutb. And they will tell you that the works of Sayyid Qutb, such as milestones, ma'alim fi tariq al, the ma'alim of Sayyid Qutb, is what made them pump. And I met many of them in the UK, many of them. They read the milestones, and from that they took the permissibility of robbing money from the government here. They go to shops, they rob money, yeah? They take the kuffar's money, old pension ladies in malls and shopping centers. They take their necklaces and their gold and their purses and their bags because they believe that they are in Darul Harb. They're fighting with the kuffar here in this country. So this is something, ya ikhwa, it has to be spoken about, li'annaha. And the reason why I like this concept to be dealt with is that internal problems takes precedence over the external problems. The internal problems takes. Now I want to talk about the reasons that allows takfir to spread in the ummah. What is it that allows it? And how? What causes it to spread? The first, ya ikhwa, is al-jahlu bid-deen, ignorance of the religion. If you look at Sayyid Qutb's nash'a and his talaqi, his upbringing, his nurturing, you will never find that he has a chain for knowledge. He took no knowledge from no alim. And that alim took from another alim, and then that alim took from another alim. No, none of that. He was in prison, became emotional, he read some books here and there, he then wrote tafsir as he saw it to be, and he did takfir of the mujtama'at. Rather, every individual of them, if you observe them and you look at them, you find that their upbringing and their background has no alaqa and no relationship with no scholar. They have no sanad. Sahih? And you all know the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ in Sunnah Abi Dawood, that the Prophet ﷺ, he said, تَسْمَعُونَ وَيُسْمَعُ مِنْكُمْ وَيُسْمَعُ مِمَّنْ سَمِعَ مِنْكُمْ. You guys would hear, and it would be heard from you guys. And those who heard from you would be heard from. I mean, this religion is sanad, bis asanid. Sah? The Sahabis took it from the Prophet, we took it, they took it, tabi, tabi, took it, and it came, and it came to us through that chain, from ulama. As for a person who rips a page out of a book, or he opens a book and he just reads it, and he becomes emotional from a book that he read, and has not in any way, form or shape studied with the ulama and the people of knowledge, then this person will come definitely with ta'amat, harm and problem. Huh? that will come from it. So the first reason, ikhwani, is al-jahlu bid-deen, ignorance of the religion. Ignorance of the religion. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, when he spoke about the simat ahl al-bid'ah, the signs of the innovators, he mentions that the innovators are, their problem is compounded of two things. Number one is ignorance of the religion and oppression. You find both of them in them. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said about al-Bakri, who was refuting him. Ibn Taymiyyah said, al-Radu ala al-Bakri, he says, وَهَذِهِ الطَّرِيقَةَ الَّتِي سَلَكَهَا هَذَا, this path in which Bakri has taken, وَأَمْثَالُهُ, and the likes of him, هِيَ طَرِيقَةُ أَهْلِ الْبِدَعِ, is the path of the innovators. Okay? الَّذِينَ يَجْمَعُونَ, that combine between what? بَيْنَ الْجَهْلِ وَالظُّلْمِ, they combine between ignorance and oppression. He's ignorant, he doesn't know anything about the deen. He's supporting a group of people, ya akhi, you don't know nothing. And then you're oppressive. You're oppressing those who are opposing you, but you don't know nothing. And you have no understanding of the religion. مَعَذَٰلِكَ, and even then, you are what? You're championing, you're shouting, you're screaming with the top of your lungs for an ideology and a belief you don't even understand. So he says, الَّذِينَ يَجْمَعُونَ بَيْنَ الْجَهْلِ وَالظُّلْمِ فَيَبْتَدِعُونَ بِدْعَةً مُخَالِفَةً لِلْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ وَإِجْمَعِ الْأُمَّةِ. They what? They innovate an innovation that's in opposition to the Kitab and the Sunnah and the Ijma' of the Ummah. وَيُكَفِّرُونَ مَنْ خَالَفَهُمْ فِي بِدْعَةٍ. And then they place takfir on those who oppose them. He made up this. It's all in his mind. It goes against the Kitab and the Sunnah and the Ijma'. And then what he does is that he makes takfir on those who oppose him in it. And he says, وَأَئِمَّةُ السُّنَّةِ وَالْجَمَاعَةِ, أَهْلُ السُّنَّةِ وَالْجَمَاعَةِ وَأَهْلُ الْعِلْمِ وَالْإِيمَانِ, and people of faith and iman and knowledge. فِيهِمُ الْعِلْمِ, they have with them knowledge. وَالْعَدْلِ, they are just. وَالْرَحْمَةِ, and they are very merciful. فَيَعْلَمُونَ الْحَقَّ الَّذِي يَكُونُونَ بِهِ مُوَافِقِينَ لِلسُّنَّةِ, they know the truth that will allow them to be on the sunnah. They have knowledge of that. سَالِمِينَ مِنَ الْبِدْعَةِ, and they also know that which will protect them from falling into their innovation. They have knowledge of all that. وَيَعْدِلُونَ عَلَى مَنْ خَرَجَ مِنْهَا, and they are also just on those who even oppose the sunnah and fall into innovation. They don't lie about them. They don't say, oh, he fell into innovation. Wallahi, I'm going to throw everything at him. I'm just going to make lies about him. No, they are just. They don't say about them what they haven't said or they haven't done. وَلَوْ ظَلَمَهُمْ, even if those people oppress them, they only speak what is rightfully theirs. They don't exceed the limits and lie about the person. They are just, they are fair. So that's the first reason. الْجَهْلُ بِدِينِ اللَّهِ تَبَارَكُ وَتَعَالَى, ignorance of the religion. And when ignorance is said, brothers, it doesn't mean if that person has the biggest shahadat from the biggest, most prestigious universities. Yeah? You can have the biggest shahadat if you want. Jahal and ignorance can still be present in you. Are you with me? We find many people who have degrees in the Sharia, certificates in the Sharia, and then they don't know the foundations and the most basic matters related to the religion. Number two, اتِّبَاعُ الْهَوَىٰ وَالْإِعْرَاضُ عَنِ النُّصُوصِ. The second reason why this takfir spreads is اتِّبَاعُ الْهَوَىٰ. These people, they follow their desires. I remember I met one of these individuals who have fallen into takfir. I met him. He was a takfiri. And he still is today, till today. He said to me with his own mouth, مِنَ الْغَرَابَ بِمَكَانِ, it's غريب, how can this happen? He said to me, I didn't know Aqidah. But when I went to the University of Medina and I graduated from it, I studied Aqidah. Ya akhi, you used to do takfir before. And now you're just doing takfir. So even when you did go to the Jami'ah, you picked and chose who was in accordance to your filthy belief. اتباع الهوى, follow your desires. turning away from the nusus. That the person, guess what he does? He will only look what's in accordance to his hawa. يَعْتَقِدُونَ ثُمَّ يَسْتَدِلُّونَ فَيَضِلُّونَ. They have a preconceived notion. They have a concept already there in their head. And they will make sure that the sheikh that they listen to has to be in accordance to what's in their head. Yeah? This is a problem, ya ikhwa. It's a big problem. If you look at these takfiriyun, لا يرجعون في أحكامهم على من كفرهم إلى دليل صحيح. Wallahi, they don't ever take it to the Kitab and the Sunnah. They will never say to you, قال الله تعالى, and they'll put it on your finger on you. They'll never take you to the Sunnah and they'll say to you, this is what it is. Never. They won't do that. Number three, التأويل الفاسد. The third one is false and corrupt interpretation of the text. So even if they do bring for you, textual evidences, Kitab and Sunnah, the ta'wil and the interpretation is what? It's fasid. It is fasid and it is corrupt. They will take verses that were sent on the kuffar and they will place it on the believers. What did Al-Dhahak ibn Muzahim al-Hilali say, rahimahullah? He says, أهل نهروان, the Khawarij of Nahrawan, those Khawarij, تأولوا آيات من القرآن في أهل القبلة. He said they took verses and they placed those verses on the Muslims. وإنما أنزلت في أهل الكتاب, but those verses were sent on أهل الكتاب. جهلوا علمها, they were ignorant of its knowledge, these verses. فسفكوا بها الدماء, and because of it they spilled blood. وانتهبوا الأموال, and they robbed money. وَشَهِدُوا عَلَيْنَا بِالضَّلَالَةِ, and they have said about us that we're misguided. Even the Tabi'een had a hard time with these individuals. They were what? They were making takfir of the companions and the Tabi'een. Number four, تَلْبِيسُ الشَّيْطَانِ, the deceptions of Shaytan. Shaytan deceived these individuals. Shaytan plotted against them. And he done talbis, made something seem to them what it really isn't. And he beautified and adorned it in their hearts. And so they became what? They became the soldiers of Shaytan. ولذلك ابن الجوزي has a kitab called تلبيس إبليس, the deceptions of Shaytan. In that book he mentions تلبيس الشيطان على الخوارج, the deceptions, about the deception of Shaytan to the Khawarij. And he says the following. He says, رحمه الله, وإنما المقصود النظر في حيل إبليس وتلبيس على هؤلاء الحمقى الذين عملوا بواقعاتهم واعتقدوا أن علي بن أبي طالب على الخطأ ومن معه من المهاجرين والأنصار على الخطأ وأنهم على الصواب واستحلوا دماء الأطفال ولم يستحلوا أكل ثمرة بغير ثمنها. He said, وإنما المقصود, the intent behind this chaptering, he said, Ibn al-Jawzi, is في حيل إبليس, the way, the trickery of Iblis and his deception. عَلَى هَؤُلَاءِ الْحَمْقَى, on these dim-witted individuals. الَّذِينَ عَمِلُوا, those who have implemented. بِوَاقِعَاتِهِمْ, they implemented in their situations. They did what they wanted in their situation. وَعَتَقَدُوا, and they believed. أَنَّ عَلِيَ بْنَ أَبِي طَالِبٍ عَلَى الْخَطَأِ, that Ali is upon mistake. وَمَنْ مَعَهُ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنْصَارِ عَلَى الْخَطَئِ, and they started to believe that the muhajirin and the ansar who were with Ali are upon mistake. وَأَنَّهُمْ عَلَى الصَّوَابِ, that they are upon the truth and they are correct. وَاسْتَحَلُّوا دِمَاءَ الْأَطْفَالِ, and they made permissible for themselves the blood of the children. يا إخوة, children. وَلَمْ يَسْتَحِلُّوا, look at the shaytan deceived them. He made them not make halal for themselves أكل ثمرة بغير ثمنها. Eating fruits that fell from trees on the floor, they were seeing it impermissible to eat it because it's not your wealth. The Khawarij, they were not eating apples that fell from trees and fruits that fell from trees, but they were making permissible for themselves the blood of the companions and the students of the companions. This is talbisu iblis. And the same concept shaitan is using against them, which is what? All of the ulama of this time are wrong. They're all incorrect. And who is upon the haqq? Me and my masjid and the group that I'm with. The scholars are scholars for dollars. You see, it's the same thing that the shaitan that sent them that revelation that time, at the time of the companions, it's the same shaitan that's sending them the revelation today. وَإِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ لَيُوحُونَ إِلَىٰ أَوْلِيَائِهِمْ لِيُجَادِلُوكُمْ صح. That shaitan says revelation to his followers, right? He's the same shaitan that's whispering to them then and saying that all the sahabas are misguided, they're kuffar, is the same shaitan that's telling them today that all of the ulama of this time are all what? Scholars for dollars. And who's guided? You who don't know your alphabet. You don't know nothing about the religion. Wallahi, Kitab al-Tahara you don't know. And you're talking about Masail Iram. These ulama are kuffar. A'udhu billah. Whose beards have become white. For what? The years that they were studying and they were learning. So this, you know, that, brothers, is what? Is the deception of shaitan. Now, inshaAllah ta'ala, we're going to go into the next point, which is the definition of al-kufr, lughatan wa shara'a. What does kufr mean linguistically, the lexical meaning, and what does kufr mean in the technical shara'i term? Okay? Kufr, linguistically, it means السَّتْرُ وَالتَّغْطِيَةِ السَّتْرُ وَالتَّغْطِيَةِ السَّتْرُ means what? It's to conceal something, it's to hide something. تَغْطِيَةِ is the same. This is what it linguistically means. Something hidden. That's kufr in the linguistic Arabic meaning. Ibn Faris said that. He said, الْكَافُ وَالْفَاءُ والراء أصل صحيح يدل على معنى واحد وهو الستر والتغطية. You know Ibn Faris رحمه الله. Ibn Faris has a kitab called معجم مقاييس اللغة. This book is one of the most beneficial dictionary books. It's called معجم مقاييس اللغة. It's one of the most beneficial books of what? One of the most beneficial, if not the most beneficial book when it comes to the Arabic what? The Arabic dictionary, the reason why. Ibn Faris, if a word has been explained linguistically into 4, 5, 6 different meanings, he will try his best to summarize it into one or two. That all of those six can come under. He's good at bringing the word back to one fundamental meaning that encompasses all of that. So you will find in other books of dictionary that the word kufr means this or that, but it will still fall under a satr wa taghtiyah. Sah? And as a person, it's always hard for you to find if a word is it's defined with 6, 7 different meanings, you kind of sometimes get confused. It's hard to memorize all of that, right? It's better for somebody who's going to bring it back to one common definition with it that they all share. So he always does that, one or two or three, that he believes that it can all come under. He'll bring that. Yeah? Ibn Faris. He said, Al-kafu wal-fa'u wal-ra'u aslun sahihun yadullu ala ma'nan wahidin. So he believes that it goes back to one meaning. All of the meanings that scholars have mentioned in the language, he brought it to one meaning. What is it? As-satr wa-taghtiyah. As-satr wa-taghtiyah, which means to conceal and hide something. So that's what it means. Go to the fifth volume, page 191. And that's exactly what the Quran did. What did the Quran say? Allah says, كَمَثَلِ غَيْثٍ أَعْجَبَ الْكُفَارَ نَبَاتُ. Allah says, kufar. The farmers are kufar. Linguistically. Okay, I'm not making takfir on farmers. The farmers are kufar here means that they take the seed and they plant it into the earth and they conceal it. Sah? Zurra', the farmers. لِأَنَّ الْمُزَارِعِ يَسْتُرُ الْبِذْرَ فِي الْأَرْضِ. He takes the bidr, which is the seed, and he conceals it by putting it into the earth and is covering it. Sah? What he's doing is called what? Kufr, which is his concealing the seed that's in the earth. That's what it means. كَمَثَلِ غَيْثٍ أَعْجَبَ الْكُفَّارَ نَبَاتُهُ. The kuffar here Allah is talking about are the farmers. The farmers. This usage in the ayah means the linguistic meaning, the lexical meaning. Okay? The shar'i definition. The shar'i definition is many. Many different, there's different definitions. Let's give some. One is the one given by Al-Azhari. عَنِ اللَّيْثِ فِي تَعْرِيفِهِ that he said, Al-Azhari mentions this in his Tahdhib al-Asma'i wal-Lughat. In his Tahdhib al-Lughah. Al-Azhari mentions in his Tahdhib al-Lughah. He says from Layth that he said, أَنَّهُ نَقِيدُ iman. That kufr is the opposite of iman. أَنَّهُ نَقِيدُ iman. It's the opposite of an iman. Al-Qarafiyu, the great Maliki scholar, he has a book called Al-Furuq. Furuq here is that he talks about differences between words and taqasim, different types. It's one of the books that benefits you. If you want two words that are so similar, what he does is that he tells you the differences between the two. It's a very good book, amazing book. One of the best books written in this. He says, Asrul kufri innama huwa. The asal, the foundation of kufr is انتهاك خاص لحرمة الربوبية. It is to انتهاك means to strip or to destroy or to eradicate. A specific type of انتهاك, specific لحرمة الربوبية. It's a sacredness of ربوبية, Allah's ربوبية. إما بالجهل, either with ignorance. So here توحيد الربوبية. He says that إِمَّا بِالْجَالِ بِوُجُودِ الصَّانِعِ أَوْ صِفَاتِهِ الْعُلَىٰ. So it's basically takfir in the issue of rububiyyah, right? Believing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's existence or Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's characteristics, he says. وَيَكُولُ الْكُفْرُ بِالْفِعْلِ. And he says kufr can also be by action. كَرَمِي الْمُصْحَفِ فِي الْقَاذُرَاتِ. Like throwing the mushaf in the bin. أَوْ السُّجُودِ لِلصَّنَمِ. Or prostrating to an idol. أو التردد للكلائس. Or keep going to the church. في أعيادهم, on their celebrations. بزين النصارى, with the clothing of the Christians. He keeps going to the, every Christmas you see him there in the church. And he wears the clothing of the bishop or the priest. Okay? You see him do that every time he's there. أو جهدي, or is to be stubborn. ما علم من الدين بالضرورة. Stubbornness to the things that are known in the religion out of necessity. كفوي, he said الكفر لغة الستر. كفوي said that the كفر linguistically means الستر وشريعة لأن الشريعة. What does it mean? عدم الإيمان عما من شأنه. Not believing in that which he should have believed in. عبد الرحمن ناصر السعدي, he said حد الكفر الجامع لجميع أجناسه وأنواعه وأفراده هو جحد ما جاء به الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أو جحد بعضه. عبد الرحمن ناصر السعدي said the definition of kufr, the most comprehensive definition for kufr that brings all of its essence and all of its types and all of its branches together, is stubbornness ما جاء به الرسول, that which a messenger came with, or stubbornness to some of it. All of those definitions which I mentioned, even that though they are different in terms of its wordings, but it's very close in terms of its meaning. And the meaning that all of those definitions revolve around is two things. Are you with me, brothers? All of those definitions, they revolve around what? Two points. It revolves around two points. The first one is the definition of kufr in terms of that which opposes it. And that was the definition of who? Al-Layth and Al-Kafawi. Al-Layth and Al-Kafawi, what did they both say? Al-Layth, what did he say? Naqid al-Iman is the opposite to Iman. What did Kafawi said? Adam al-Iman amma min sha'nihi. They're talking about the opposite of, and that which opposes Iman. Okay. The second one is defining kufr bijahdi ma ja'a bihi an-nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Stubbornness to that which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with. And this second type is ta'rifu shay'i bi ba'di afradihi. Is defining something with some of its branches of kufr. Because we believe that kufr is not only juhud. It's more than that. But they've only defined it here based on some of its branches. And they're not saying that all of kufr is mahsurun fil juhudi, that all of kufr is specific to juhud. La. Because we believe that the kufr can be based on juhud, and we're going to mention juhud, what it means in proper meaning. We believe it can be anad, stubbornness, and we'll mention the difference between juhud and anad, or is inkar, or in nifaq, or i'rad, or even shak. All of those can be kufr, as we're going to mention inshaAllah ta'ala. And we also believe that the kufr can be in terms of belief. We believe that the kufr can be in terms of speech. And we believe that the kufr can be in terms of actions. All three of them can be kufr. As we're going to, inshaAllah ta'ala, we're going to mention. There's a relationship between the kufr linguistically and technically. Akhi, can you put on the light, please? Yeah, sorry.
Just for the camera.
Yeah, and I think the sisters, can they see? Yeah, let's put this one on. So there is a relationship between the linguistic and lexical meaning and the shar'i meaning of kufr. There's a relationship between it. There's a difference. There's a relationship between the two.